more to the right, it's closer to the going downtown.
Expressway. toward US Highway 183 South.
Make a U-turn to stay on West Anderson Lane.
sunlight. Turn left on Dean Avenue.
What's going on, Blue?
How's it going?
It's going, man. It's going.
A tear drop off at 10011 Derringer Trail.
How you doing tonight, man?
I'm alright. How about yourself?
I'm doing alright.
What's the best way to go out of which exit?
You can just exit out.
Right here?
Yeah. And then just straight down.
Please use your seatbelt for your safety.
Turn right on North Lamar Boulevard, then turn right.
Did you see other cars driving around?
No.
Just me?
Yeah, just you. And you was kind of out there, man. Should I appreciate coming all the way through for the ride. Just like go around the corner.
Yeah. Well, my name is Chris, and I'm going to be your driver, and I'm recording for our safety.
All right.
Yeah, because I missed the fucking turn and shit on the freeway and shit.
Quarter mile, turn right on Masterson Pass.
Yeah, he's gonna take a right at the thing.
All right.
Turn right on Masterson.
Is there much difference between the Comfort Ride and the Uber X Ride?
I don't really know. I actually just downloaded the app tonight.
In a quarter mile, turn right on Annie Oakley Trail.
Yeah, so it's not gonna be first right, but the second right.
Move, kitty.
Yeah, I got into an accident, so I ain't got my ride no more.
Oh yeah, that sucks.
Yeah, yeah.
Was it your fault?
No.
The other person had insurance or no?
Yeah. But it's still just like the whole process.
Yeah, you got it though. You gotta go through it, you know. It sucks being without a car.
Just ahead, turn right on Derringer Trail. Turn right on Derringer Trail, then drop off.
Damn, there's some bright ass lights.
That's the high beam.
Oh.
But it just really goes higher. It doesn't go. It doesn't get brighter right there. It just goes higher.
Damn. Good right here.
On the right or the left? Or?
Good right here.
Enjoy the rest of your night.
Alrighty, man.
Yes, sir.
Keep grinding though.
Yeah, I'm trying to. 416 909. Got a $5 tip. I gotta fucking take a piss. Where's the water burger at? I think it's down that way. I need to take a piss. Thank you.
at 1903 Albarico. Make a U-turn to stay on North Lamar Boulevard. In a quarter mile, turn left on West Anderson Lane, using the left two lanes.
Oh man, this shit here is ridiculous. Thank you.
Keep right toward FM 1325 Burnett Road. In a quarter mile, turn right on Metric Boulevard using the right lane. turn right on Sun Hollow Bend. Just ahead, turn right on Albury Cove. Turn right on Albury Cove, then pick up.
Hello.
Hello. Good morning.
Good morning.
Head to your drop off at United. Make a U-turn to stay on Albury Cove, then turn left on Sun Hollow Bend.
Please use your seatbelt for your safety.
Turn left on Sun Hollow Bend.
My name's Chris, and I'm going to be your driver, and I'm recording for our safety.
Yeah.
Just ahead, turn left on Metric Boulevard.
Well, I'm renting it. I've been renting it about a month and a half. I'm not gonna lie, it's cost a lot, man. It's $465 a week, so that's almost $2,000 a fucking month. So, but I on behalf of the car is great. I love the car.
Okay.
It looks different than most cars. It charges up from 10 to about 80 in 35 minutes.
Oh, that's good.
Hey, every car has a different amount of time that it takes to charge. But this one's great. I like this car a lot. It's an electric Volvo.
Yeah.
It's an electric Volvo, so... You know, Volvos are made for safety, so... drivers are telling me, and I see what they're getting. It's the Kia EV6. It charges up in 18 minutes.
Oh, that's even faster.
Yeah. I think it has a little bit more range too. Not much. A little bit more range. Right, but it's more spacious than this car. But I'm not gonna say that it's safer than this car.
Yeah. Why did you pick the Polestar?
Well, I wanted to get the EV6. I had rented a different electric car. I had it for about a month. Put nearly 6,000 miles on it in a month. And I wanted a premier car that I could do the premier rides, even though they're few and far in between. But it's like $85 more a week. But this is only the premier car they had. But I like it a lot. Yeah, cause I tried to rent a gas car, and then the guy was like, "Oh, we only have this one electric car. I don't know if that's the spill they use or the ploy they use or." Probably both. Because with that, at that Avis, you're required to get the insurance on it. But I rented this from Hertz, you're not required to get the insurance on it. But even though I did.
In a quarter mile, see, turn
I live
right
in San Antonio, and people do not know how to drive, and they don't have insurance in San Antonio. So I didn't want to take the chance of getting hit and then having to pay the $2,000 deductible.
Research Boulevard.
Do you live in the Austin area?
No, I live in San Antonio.
Oh, you actually live in San Antonio.
Yeah, I live in San Antonio. Okay. It's like an hour, a little over an hour to drive over here.
Turn to stay on Research Boulevard.
There's more money over here. Because everybody, mostly in San Antonio, they just use Uber X. They rarely use the Uber Comfort, or the Uber, much less the Uber Premier. And those rides bring the more money. That's the damn. I guess it's on this side.
Just ahead, keep left toward U.S. Highway 183 South.
I came this weekend, but I didn't feel like coming Saturday. I mean Sunday.
Toward U.S. Highway 183 South.
For Saturday, going into Sunday, should I made $525? But that's through the whole 12 hours.
So you drive a lot each day.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I try to max it out. Because I have to pay for this car, and it costs $465 is a lot for a week. That's some people's paycheck, man. So. Yeah, I'll put $1,500 easy in a week. Decided, I said, man, I may as well just sacrifice that hour and a half or hour and a half each way to make more money.
Do people usually take an Uber from, well, do you find people take Uber from Austin to San Antonio and back and like from or from San Antonio to Austin?
I've had a couple of rides from San Antonio Airport to the airport over here, and then another one was from the airport to their house over here. it's from the airport usually. But the other one, it wasn't from the airport. It was from a hotel to the airport over here. I dropped, I picked somebody up from a bus station Thursday morning. I dropped them off in Kyle. So I was like, man, I wasn't going to be able to make it back on that charge I had, so I had to come over here to charge it up some. Charge point, I go to the EVgo.
Oh, I see. Yeah, because that's a fast charger.
Yeah, those charge points, it has to be a bigger one.
Yeah, level 3, because like the level 2 charges a little bit slower.
Yeah, I'm not gonna. Like that time I came and dropped the lady off at the airport, man, I said like I had 20 miles to play with, which shit, it was blinking. It was blinking like 5 miles. I said, man, please let me let this lady make it to her flight, man. And then I was looking for a charger there at the airport, and then they had some chargers there, but like the charge point, the faster charger, that sucker was broke, man. So I had to plug up to one of the slow ones, and when I plugged it up, it was before 7 in the morning, and it said it wasn't going to be charged till 7 p.m. I'm like, oh man. So I took about a 45-minute nap. When I woke up, it had 20 miles on it, so I went to EVgo charge station. Yeah, I really don't use charge point. Even though there's some in San Antonio that I can use that charge fast, and I just usually, I guess I'm a creature of habit, I always go to the same one.
Yeah, I get it.
But over here there's like 3 different ones that I'll go to. Depending where I'm at. San Antonio, it is busy till like from 4 o'clock to 10 o'clock. I'm anticipating the same over here because I haven't been doing it on the week, just so solely over here. And so I just started doing it solely over here. So this is no point of me driving to San Antonio for like $22, and when I can come over here and make closer to 40.
What time did you start driving today?
Today, I left San Antonio by 10 o'clock. Got over here about 11:15, maybe. I charged it up. It was maybe a little past. So I was like, I'm going to leave it charging until I get a ride. Over there off of Slaughter exit 127 coming this way. So I was just sitting there waiting for a Comfort ride or a Premier ride, which a Comfort usually come, not Premier as often. And I got it up to like 90 something, a little over 90. The people were right down the street, and then I dropped them off downtown. So about a little after 12, I started.
When do you finish?
I'm gonna try to do the whole 12 unless I get too damn sleepy. So I'll probably charge maybe one, maybe two more times. that'll be like hour and a half maybe, depends. So probably about, I'll finish about 2, maybe 3 o'clock in the afternoon, maybe. Then I'm gonna go back home, go to sleep, and do it again.
How long have you been driving for Uber?
I did the Uber Eats for about 10 months, and I'm doing this for about 2.5 months. The ride share. 2.5 months.
All the time.
There's more of the crazy people outside of the car than inside of the car. But I had a couple of crazy ones inside the car, though. I'm not intimidated. I grew up in Houston, so. Yeah, but some drivers are more particular than others. I'm not, like some, if you're smoking a cigarette, they're not going to let you in the car. When I see people vaping or smoking cigarettes, I just tell them, say, man, not me, but other drivers might not let you in the car. So when you see them pulling up, don't puff the shit out the cigarette, but put it out ahead of time. I said, this is for y'all benefit, not mine. I'm still gonna give them a ride. Time somebody they put the stuff out the car, they wanted me to stop so they could get out.
Texas 71 East.
Then they gave me a one rating, said I was passing lights and speeding and all this other shit. It doesn't matter what they say about me because I already got like almost all 5 stars. So, but for them, me giving them a one rating and putting the person's behavior, it'll affect them more because it'll kick them off the platform. I ain't trying to do all that, but I give everybody 5 stars, but they kick themselves out. I already know what they was going to do. Give me 1 star. It didn't matter to me. Because almost all of them are 5 stars. So. I think out of 500, only 12 of them are 5 stars. Want me to get on tow road, right?
In a half mile, keep left toward Texas 71 East,
yeah,
using the
I
left
don't
two
care
lanes.
Because like my work is paying for this.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Well, tow road it is.
Yeah, I just want to get to the airport as soon as possible.
Yeah. So it's this lane, right?
I don't know.
Yeah, then one time I was supposed to pick somebody up at the airport because I dropped somebody off. I went around it like three or four times already. They called me and said, sir, I'm not from over here. I'm trying to get my way in there. They canceled the ride. I'm like, it's going to cost them more, not me.
Yeah, the Uber area at the Austin airport is a bit weird. Because, like, you have to get into the parking structure.
Yeah.
Through the parking structure.
The red or the blue entrance, right?
Yeah.
being by these trucks, man, because they'll get over and they don't give a fuck.
To stay on Highway 71 east toward Austin Bergstrom International Airport Barbara Jordan Terminal using the right lane.
Well, just say it, it's never a dull moment doing this. See, that's trucks all over the place now. I'll give you your space, bro. That's because you ain't even in a big truck. You're in a little box truck.
Yeah, I just picked up some lady.
She told me she was homeless. I didn't know what to tell her.
See,
somebody, I guess somebody gave her a ride.
I'll
just tell her, say, God doesn't put on you more than you can handle. You know?
Just ahead, keep right on Presidential Boulevard using the right lane.
I'm just trying to give her some words of confidence. Cause, yeah.
Keep right on Presidential Boulevard.
I love to drive, but I'm not familiar with the area, man. For close to, see, I got 119. When I drop you off, it's like 20, I think 20, maybe a little over 20. That'll be like, what, 3 hours? So it'll be like 130, 3 hours. Yeah, but I would only have 60 in 3 hours in San Antonio, you know, so. Yes, I have an issue too. I have trust issues, you know. I don't
continue straight to stay on Presidential Boulevard.
For a stranger to sit behind me takes a lot out of me, man.
Oh, yeah.
But I'm in control of the car, so. You know, it's a trusting relationship that we have to have. Y'all have to trust us, and we have to trust y'all. So.
Continue straight to stay on Presidential Boulevard.
Hey, but you never know. So, it was in El Paso. Because, you know, an Uber driver got killed in San Antonio.
Continue
about
continue straight to stay on Presidential Boulevard.
About 2 months ago,
right,
maybe
two
a little less than 2 months ago.
That's crazy.
Yeah, and then Uber driver got killed in El Paso. She thought the driver was trying to take her to Mexico, and she shot him in the head. So I told one of the riders.
The
they
right.
told me they're from over there, and they said, "Yeah, she got locked up for that shit. She got to go to trial for that." I don't know when it's kind of messed up on both ends, you know. He paid with his life, and she might have
to pay with
her life. So, man. But you can't just be shooting people, man.
Yeah.
So United's right here, yeah, right. Where are you flying to?
Denver.
Is it cold over there right now?
I hope not. It's in the 60s and 70s. So, yeah. Thank you so much.
Yes, sir. Enjoy your flight, sir. Have a good one.
Yeah.
Clip your arm.